An autopsy results today could reveal what killed Corey Haim. Haim died yesterday morning after collapsing in his apartment in Los Angeles. He was 38 years old. The coroner's office said that no illegal drugs were found at Haim's home. Haim was close friends with fellow actor Corey Feldman. They even starred in a reality show together. Feldman's wife, Susie, was also on the show, and she joins us on the telephone right now. Susie, good morning. Thank you for joining us.
Good morning.
And our condolences to you on the loss of your friend. Can you tell us the last time that you saw Corey and the condition that he was in when you saw him?
I actually saw him at, my Corey's house. I was picking up my son, as part of a arrangement with our son. I pick him up from Corey's house, and Haim was there. And he was, he came down and he greeted me from upstairs, and he looked great. He put on some healthy weight, and he was all smiles, and we talked for maybe a minute or two, not very long. And, I kind of packed up my son and left. I didn't stay very long, and he looked and sounded, fine. And this was about maybe 2 weeks ago. Just definitely happy as always, but starting to look, a little bit healthier because he'd put on some weight, which was good, in no way did I think, in a couple of weeks he's going to be gone.
Yeah, we've all read about Corey Haim's history and problems with drugs, but I've also been reading about how recently he's gone out of his way to make sure that his world is very clean, that the movie set that he was working on, he insisted be clean of any kind of drugs or problems. Was that your experience with him, that he really seemed to have turned his life around when it came to drug problems?
After we filmed the Two Corys, and he and I really kind of stopped staying in touch, and I don't know in the last couple years any details of any, abuse or not abuse. I just know from the running into him here and there, the different stages I would see him in as far as his appearance. But then again, that would just be speculation, and, I feel like that would be inappropriate at this point,
Sure.
But I do know that, his mother was diagnosed with breast cancer, and I know that he was really trying to get himself together for her and be there for her. And I mean, he was taken to the hospital and sitting there with her during her, her chemotherapy treatments. And I know that that was really kind of a wake-up call to him.
Yeah.
And he really wanted to take care of his mom. So that's stuff that I do know as far as, like, his daily anything, We stopped being close.
Sure.
A couple years ago, so
I don't know.
What can
you tell us about how the other Corey, your Corey Feldman, is dealing with the loss of his friend?
Not very well. Not very well. He's had a rough year. And, he lost Michael Jackson last year, and that was really tough on him. His grandfather died last year. We are currently going through a separation, a divorce. And then he loses his, childhood friend. This is all in a matter of 8 months. He has had a pretty rough time, and he's trying to deal with it. He's got press camped out on his lawn, and, he and I talk every day because of our son, so he and I are still friends, and I feel terrible for him. I mean, I just kind of want to go over and give him a hug, but
sure.
He's got so much media surrounding him. I guess he's had to do some, dodging of paparazzi and things like that.
I'm sure it's got to be very difficult. Susie,
yeah.
We appreciate
he's
you
not,
taking...
Yeah, it's not we, doing very well.
Yeah, thank you. We appreciate you taking some time to join us and share your insights into that.
Thank you.
Susie Feldman, thank you very...
You're welcome, and I just want to say thank you to Corey's fans, Haim's fans, because that's what honestly kept him going the last 5-6 years that I've known him. What kept him going was his fans. So I just want to say thank you to those people.
Thank you very much. Susie Feldman, we appreciate you joining us. Thanks very much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.